All right, Shalom. I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Ba'asham Yahushai. Give double honors to the apostles of great ministry, not real well. Salutations to the men of the hopeful and sincere elect. This is Makazar from the Trinidad camp. Just want to bring out a quick, little lesson, concerning basically the conduct that men are supposed to have as being a part of the truth, being men of the Lord. All right? And I believe I'll entitle it, Sometimes Israelites. Alright, because we're not supposed to be or to see like these Christians who only holy, Sunday morning, wherever the case is, wherever they choose to go to the harlot house. Actually, we ought to be like this all the time, because this is not something to do. There is not a boys group or a club or wherever the case is. There's actually a way of life. Alright? The scripture said, the Lord say he will give us a heart to know him. Alright? And basically, in that day, we're going to go off. But now we're actually rehearsing for it. So if the Lord going to give us a perfect heart that we may know him and always be righteous, guess what? We had to be rehearsing that from now. So we always had to be in our mindset of always being men of the Lord, rehearsing men of righteous acts. All right? I'm going to bring out these scriptures real quick. This is Matthew chapter 5, verse 14. It says, ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on an hill cannot be hid. Alright? So the Lord sent us to be fishers of men. And now the thing about being in this truth and fishing is that you never stop fishing. You don't ever stop. Alright? When you're not doing the works out there on the highways and byways, you might just be walking in the street going to work. But people know you from being out there doing the works. So guess what? They always had their eyes on you. So guess what? If your action, just as a simple thing as your actions, your conduct, your daily conduct, could actually, convert a man to doing right. All right, that could actually be the scripture says, let every man be persuaded in his own mind. That could actually be that man's persuasion, just the way you carry about yourself, because he actually see that you're true about what you're doing, and you're not a hypocrite. You're not only being righteous when you have all your garments. And actually, some men, it have some men being like that. They only righteous in front of the camera. But behind the camera, they being a nigger. Every live down there. And that ain't supposed to be. Because the scripture said, we're supposed to be pleasing the Most High, not men. Alright? We are supposed to please men. But guess what? You're actually seeking to please the Most High. Because evidently, at the end of the day, is basically the Lord you're trying to impress. Alright? And when you're being righteous or being holy, somewhat holy in front of the camera alone, guess what? You're being a damn hypocrite. Alright? You're being a nigger behind the camera, but in front of the camera, you're more holy and righteous than anything else. Guess what? You're being a hypocrite. And the scriptures say, deceiving your own self. Alright? So you said, a candle that is upon a hill cannot be hid. So you coming out there and doing the works, the Lord put a light upon it. Guess what? You become a candle upon a hill. So therefore, all eyes on you. You've been put in that spotlight. So therefore, you have to conduct yourself 24/7. It says, neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine, so shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. So they're supposed to see your good works and glorify the Most High, Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai, through your behavior, through your conduct, through your words, through your behavior. Alright? So we're not supposed to be in the streets acting all nigger-like. Alright, being a nigger. Alright, just fooling around, clowning around. We're not supposed to be that. Alright? You know, sometimes you might link up with the Akium, drink a little yan-yan. Even that, you're not supposed to let the yan-yan get to your head. Let the wine get to your head. Getting all disorderly in the streets. Alright? That is bullshit. You can't be a part of this truth and acting like a child. You have to act like a man. Paul said, when I was a child, I spoke as a child. But when I became a man, I put away all childish things. So you're supposed to be men in this. Alright? Not boys. Alright? Scripture said, unto you, O men I call, not boys. Alright? This is 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19. It says, what? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit which is in you, which ye have of Yahweh? Ye are not your own. See, we don't belong to yourself. Paul said, my prisoner to Yahweh Shai. All right? For ye are bought with a price, therefore glorify Yahweh in your body and in your spirit, which is Yahweh. So your works, even your tongue, supposed to glorify the Lord. The scripture says, let no corrupt communication proceed out of thy mouth. So even your actions and your words supposed to be glorifying the Lord in front of the camera and behind the camera. All right? Because guess what? Spiritual men will see through that charade. Where you're just acting in front of the camera. Spiritual men, guess what? The apostles saying that you're actually literally acting through the camera. See, before the Lord come, the scripture say, in Ecclesiastical 7, basically examine yourself before the day of judgment. So get your act together, because there are trouble almost here. So clean up your act before the Lord come. All right? Time short. This 1 Corinthians 4:9. It says, for I think that Yahweh had set forth the apostles last, as it were appointed unto death. For we are made a spectacle unto the world, and unto angels, and unto men. So we made a spectacle unto everybody. Everybody had their eyes on us. So even when we're not fishing, while out there on the highways and byways, we're still fishing when we're just being on an average casualty. All right, because people looking at us, people looking at your conduct. So your conduct supposed to be holy all the time. When you go to the scriptures, scriptures say search the scriptures. You never see these men getting on disorderly when they're not doing the work, or when they're from people they're acting holy, and when on our other day they're acting all unholy. Nah, you gotta be holy all the time. All right, scripture says strive for the truth. You gotta strive for perfection. All right. This is boom, 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 boom. This Galatians 5 verse 24. And they that are Mashiachs have crucified the flesh with their affections and lusts. So you have to crucify the flesh with your affections and lusts. All them things that your flesh designed to do, rebuke the flesh. Paul say that I keep myself under subjection. Alright, when you look up that word subjection, it actually means to beat blue back. It means to beat blue black. Like you're going in a fist fight with yourself. You're actually giving yourself a black eye just to keep it in subjection, just to keep it under control so that you wouldn't go off. Alright? You gotta beat yourself into subjection. So you gotta crucify that flesh. Alright? Paul said, wretched man that I am. Alright? So you gotta keep your flesh under subjection and not be a niggard when you're out there in the streets. Alright? Even when you're doing the works, control yourself. The scriptures talk about being temperate. Means self-control. Control yourself. Alright? If you consider yourself Yahweh Shai, guess what? You will keep yourself under subjection. Okay, you wouldn't like for the Lord to come down here and keep you in subjection. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. So you have to also walk in the Spirit. If you consider yourself to be a spiritual man, and guess what? The scripture say, show me thy faith, and I will show you my faith by my works. So if you consider yourself a spiritual man, then show it. Alright? What the Lord said in Proverbs 8, it says what? I was daily his delight. So you had to always be the Lord's delight, daily be the Lord's delight. The scripture says, grieve not the Holy Spirit. Alright, so you're not supposed to be grieving the Lord. You're supposed to be always the Lord's delight. Yeah, the scripture says the just man falls 7 times. Sometimes we will fall short because of this flesh. But guess what? You are actually try your best to persevere at all times. Alright? Verse 26, it says, let us not be desirous of vainglory. Alright, trying just to make a name for yourself. Because it's actually we glorifying the Lord. Provoking one another, envying one another. Alright, so we had to walk according to the flesh and not according to the spirit and not according to the flesh. Alright, let's bring this last precept here. This is Deuteronomy chapter 4. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 5. It says, behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments, even as Yahweh, my power, had commanded me, that ye should do so in the land where you go to possess it. And where did Moses teach the children of Israel? He taught them the laws in the wilderness so that when they go in the land, they wouldn't defy the land. So they had to be perfect before they go into the land. So guess what? The Lord ain't gonna take us from this kingdom and put us in the holy city and teach us the laws there for us to defy the land. That is what he's doing right now. He's sanctifying us, he's cleansing us so that we could be holy vessels to enter into the kingdom. Alright? So you're deceiving yourself by thinking that once you're in this truth, you're sealed. The scripture says, if you abide in me and my words in you. So you had to abide in the truth, and also the Lord's word had to abide in you. And if the Lord's word abided in you, then guess what? You're going to do the things that the Lord said all times, not sometimes. Alright? Not wiling out, being a nigger. You have to control yourself. People always looking at you. The scripture says, do nothing to bring shame to the ministry. So you have to control yourself. These scoffers always looking for a reason to scoff. Don't give them reason to scoff. Scripture said, suffer for the truth, but don't suffer as a thief and a murderer and whatnot. Alright? If somebody had to speak evil against the truth, let it be because why? Because of the good works that you do. And they're mocking and scoffing at the good works. But let it don't scoff because you're doing bullshit on your behalf and bring shame to the ministry. Alright? Verse 6, Deuteronomy 4 and 6, it says, keep therefore and do them, for this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations, which shall hear all these statutes and say, surely, this is a great nation. This great nation is a wise and understanding people. Alright? So, even all the people supposed to look at you and say, yeah, boy, these are mighty Lord. Wise and understanding. His way is different from ours. I want to be like this man. That is how people are supposed to be speaking of you. Alright, but you actually giving them a reason to speak evil. And not because of the word, but because you're just literally doing shit. You've been a child. You don't cut that shit out. You don't control yourself at all times. Alright, you don't control yourself at all times. So with that, you know, just want to shed them few words. Alright, want to give our praises to Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahushai. Give double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone that rule well. Apostle Taha, Apostle Rukah, Apostle Gaba, Apostle Aram Lab, all the way down. All the elders, all the sincere Akim out there. You know, part of the hopefully elect. Until next time, I say Shalom.